OCT starts as time domain modality. Recently, we have the spectral domain and the swept source. The goal of my talk is to explain the difference between these different modalities. So, time domain, we use a monochromatic light. The other two, we use a broadband light. OCT is an abbreviation for optical coherent tomography. We know that light wave, the distance between peaks is the wavelength. One complete oscillation is called a cycle. Any portion of the cycle is called a phase. The fraction of a cycle by which one leads the other is known as phase difference. In the top part, there is no phase difference. In the middle part, we have constant phase difference. In the bottom, we have a variable phase difference. So the first part, we have rays that are in phase. They are formed of the same wavelength. The middle one, we have rays out of phase with a constant phase difference. They are made of the same wavelength. The bottom one, we have out of phase rays with variable phase difference. They are made of different wavelengths. The middle one is called coherent light, and this is what is used in case of OCT time domain, while the bottom one is used in case of spectral domain or swept source OCT. Tomography means imaging bisection, like when we may ask for CT brain or CT body. OCT relies on interference. When two waves of light travel along the same path, the effect produced depends on whether or not waves are in phase or out of phase with one another. Here they are in phase and we have constructive interference. They add to one another. Here they are out of phase and we have destructive interference. Time domain OCT, we have a monochromatic light. This is diode light reaching a beam splitter. Half will go into the eye, the second half will go into a mirror. Light comes back from both. They interfere together, reaching to a detector. The mirror is movable to get in focus several different layers of the retina. So we have light to a beam splitter. Half will reach into the eye, the other half to the mirror. Will meet a surface. Light is reflected back. Interference occurred and felt at the detector. Notice here, I draw light here in yellow. The peak of this light is on the anterior surface of this layer. Here I draw light, but the peak is on the posterior surface of the here or the anterior surface of the next layer. The rays I draw here in blue on coming back will cause destructive interference. So this everything happens at the same time. The first one they add to one another and the detector will feel that there is interference here. The second one destroys one another and nothing will be felt at that level. So everything here should be drawn over each other, but I make this separation just for the explanation. Constructive interference is observed at the maximum intensity when the optical path of both arms are exactly equal. By moving the mirror, we can see different layers one by one. This is the same. I'm going to explain one more time. I just make split of the image into two. Light coming, reaching the anterior surface of the layer. The peak of the light is on the anterior surface of the layer, so we have constructive interference. At the same time, light coming from the second interface induces destructive interference. So at this position, the detector will receive light from the anterior interface, nothing from the posterior interface. But when the mirror moves a little bit back, the distance will differ, and at this new position, the detector will feel the second interface and not the first one. Light is pushed in very micro pulses. Now, what about the spectral interference? This is found in case of spectral domain and swept source OCT. Here we use a broad band, not a monolight, but all bands of light are there. The spectral domain depends on fast Fourier transfer. It is called spectral domain or called frequency domain. What is the fast Fourier transfer? If we have waves of light, in this drawing we have three waves with three different wavelengths with three different frequencies. When these three waves are passing together, this is the result that we have. This configuration of waves. When we change the receiver to frequency, then instead of seeing such a thing, it will receive only three bands. One band at a frequency of the first wave, second reflection at the frequency of the second, and a third reflection at the frequency of the third. So this way, the machine can feel that it got three frequencies. So any compound waves formed of so many waves, the Fourier transfer, when it is applied, it shows us how many waves are there and showing the reflection of each one frequency separately. So this way we can separate a mixture of waves into separate ones. So here some sinusoidal waves will give this appearance, but applying the FFT we have several separate frequencies. Now we have light coming, and this is the surface of the retina, the different layers of the retina. This is one of the waves. As you notice here, at this point the light is at peak, so the reflection is maximum, but here and there the reflection with the interference will be destructive. This another wave, the reflection here is at a peak, while the reflection at these two levels is at the bottom. A third one, you have here the reflection at a peak, while in the last two, the reflection is at the bottom. So when everything is reflected back to interfere with that of the mirror, the detector will have reflection maximum here for that color, and here for that second color, and here for that third color. So with the different wavelengths, the detector can detect we have three separate layers. The Fourier transfer is at this location. Different waves mix it together, but the detector using the Fourier transfer principle can feel that we have only three frequencies. So that's the idea, to through to the eye broadband with different waves, and the reflection is different from each layer, and the detector can separate them together. So here we don't depend on mirror movement. That's why this way of photography is very quick. It depends on the velocity of light, not on the mechanical movement of a mirror. The image sensor can detect the intensity of each frequency detected corresponding to certain elements within a tissue. Keep in mind that we receive reflections of light, bright one, dimmer one, more dim, bright, dim, and so on. And what colors we see is artificial colors. So again, this is the idea, broad band, different colors, reflection is different depending on the wavelengths. Reaching here, interference will happen, but the Fourier transfer will change them into separate frequencies so we can identify different interfaces. The time domain is a slow process being dependent on mechanical movement of a mirror. So this slow process allow the eye movement to be captured. This will induce artifact. The scans are only 400 scans per second. On the other hand, the Fourier transfer, the scans are very much higher, 26,000 up to 40,000 per second. This is very fast than the eye movement, so image is much stable. Resolution is better, it's 5 microns compared to the time domain, which is 10 microns. And also, this very fast move, this very fast capturing of the image allow us to have what's known as the OCT angiography that we are going to discuss in another presentation. What about the spectra swept source OCT? Again, it's a broadband light, but here the separation of the waves is at the level of the source. So we have a narrow line width that gradually swept through the spectrum to send different wavelengths. In case of a spectral domain, the separation was at the level of the detector, but here the separation is at the level of the source. It had the advantage of showing deeper structures like the laminar cribrosa or the deep choroidal vessel. Spectral domain can show to a little extent these deep structures when using a technique known as enhanced depth imaging by pushing the instrument closer to the eye and take photography, but the quality is less than received with the swept source OCT. So the last two, the spectral domain and the swept source, have the same technology. But the spectral domain, the separation is at the level of the detector, while the sweep source, the separation, is at the source of light itself. So to sum up, time domain, it's a monochromatic light, depends on a movable mirror, so the resolution is poor and eye movement are there, detected while capturing the image. Spectral domain, it's a broad spectrum light, separation occurs at the level of the detector. Sweep source, the source itself, it's a narrow light that change through the spectrum. The sweep source give us image to deeper structures better than the spectral domain. Thank you for your attention.